Be cool if the planets had poles and different weather. Oh, yeah. Oh, absolutely. They also need better skyboxes. These skyboxes make me sad. I'd actually rather not even have this, like, shitty cloud texture. Like, if you want to see really nice-looking clouds, it's not the same, but go look at Astroneer. I've been playing a lot of that recently, and that game is awesome. And that game has wonderful-looking planets along the way. What if you found tribes and huts are spawning? Yeah, oh yeah, it'd be interesting if there were hive enemies. Dude, I'd love it if there was kind of the equivalent of the buggers from Ender's Game. Imagine if you like came out of space and there's just a giant hive growing out of a planet, and they immediately just start trying to kill you. How sweet would that be? The answer is pretty freaking sweet. I would really enjoy that. I have no plutonium. I guess we'll hit up this plutonium, then we'll charge my thing the rest of the way. There's a third one here. There it is. Like, I'd take that over the, like, aping off of Halo, getting the flood thing. Because it would be pretty damn sweet if there was, like, a whole solar system that's, like, totally just screw you levels of angry and want to kill you. Yeah, not the Zerg. Kinda. But, like, it would be awesome if you could come across that stuff out here. Not another one of you. At least they die fast. A lot of zinc around here, too. I should probably collect it, but it's pretty easy to get my hand on. Where's my ship? Yeah, I'm just gonna head for my ship. It's not that interesting. But yeah, I don't know. I need to see some semblance of a society for the existing sentient species. The fact that there are only three sentient species is really weird to me. But yeah, let players terraform stuff. Oh yeah, that'd be great if I could like start just slapping down all sorts of stuff, more or less like slowly converting a planet into my dream paradise and stuff like that. That'd be awesome. Let's see, I think that's where my base is. I'm assuming, seeing as I've got a beacon there. It just might be overriding. That's okay. But yeah, I don't know. I want something. And while the base building update was good, I really need some more to, like, stick my, to sink my teeth into. Because it's not fun. I like the idea of three sentient spacefaring species in No Man's Sky, because the grand scheme of things, life is rare. Oh no, I don't disagree with that. It's just you only have three of them, and they don't have a society. There's nothing there. Let's see, think about it. In our universe, there's only one sentient species. We have no way of knowing if we're alone in the universe, which is terrifying. Personally, I like the idea of there being huge numbers of sentient species. I just have no idea if we're ahead of the... if we're ahead of the curve or behind it. Because that's kind of scary. I really liked... okay, I don't know how many of you guys read sci-fi. Oh, sweet, you can actually see my freighter. That's actually really cool looking. Okay, that's something I want. That is 100% something I want. Pointing at that freighter above my base. I want to see freighters just hanging out. Not like these weird clusters that do nothing. I want to see a freighter landing at... not landing on a planet, but like coming down to a trading post and having a bunch of ships going up and down to it and then leaving and stuff like that. Or, you know, it docking to a special port on a space station and doing something. Like, that looked really cool. And banned. Okay. Like, that looked really cool. And that's a sight I will only see because of mine. But yeah, I was talking about, Old Man's War. Old Man's War is, probably my favorite sci-fi book I've ever read. Like, hands down. It's just such a wonderfully written book, in my opinion. And one of the main premises for it... Wow, that's a lot of iridium. I probably didn't need this much. Whatever. Let's see. Let's just discard the emerald. We don't need it. Let's see. I need shielding shards. I need to sell some stuff. Okay. But yeah, in Old Man's War, humanity kind of joins the Interstellar Society late in the game, and as such, they're like a little bit behind, sort of. But they end up allying with, oh, starship out of range. What? Oh, I'm out of range of my own starship. I gotcha. But you know, they kind of end up, joining Spacefaring Society late, and it kind of, it doesn't backfire, but like, you know, puts humanity into a bad situation and stuff like that. And I actually really thought that was cool. And so, you know, that we actually were fine-ish. Okay. Right. We need Rigogen. Balls. We're gonna have to find that somewhere. Okay, so I can take that up. What was the other... I need something from one other person here. But yeah, it's terrifying to think that the first sentient life we come across is going to be angry and will hate us. Okay, so we need insulating gel from a scientist. Did you need candesium? Okay, temerium... Why did I need candesium? Alright, I totally forgot. I deleted the guy from the universe. Okay, let's see. What can I make? Maybe it's something I needed to make. Oh. It was candesium and antrium to make non-ferrous plates, and I should have a bunch of that now. Glass, polyfiber. Circuit boards. What was the... Oh, I needed this for a landing pad. Okay, well... I don't think we need any more antrium. We definitely don't need any more candesium. I'm probably loaded on that. So let's go back to the station we're on. And... sell some of this junk, because we are loaded on a ton of... we're loaded with a ton of things, and I need to go get more of that temerium. Which we're kind of lucky for. Rigogen, we're going to have to go wildly out of our way for. I really wish I could just buy it off of somebody. But I guess that would kind of trivialize this whole glorified fetch quest that I'm on. It is cold as shit in here. Then again, it's... What is the temperature outside? I was talking about what... I was complaining about how cold it was. Ah. I do not want to emergency dial 911 phone. Thank you for... Oh, hey, there's the heat. And... Oh, no, it's only 2 degrees. Still. Cold. That's okay. Guess this would explain why I slept in so late and stuff. But yeah, no, I'm personally, like, terrified of the idea that, you know, at some point in my lifetime, aliens are just gonna show up and just be like, yeah, we want your planet. I'm gonna be like, why? Why? And then, you know, it doesn't matter because we get wiped off the liquidator. Bori? What do you do? Oh, he's an armorer. With a name like Liquidator, I thought he was going to be like a trade mogul. Do you ever miss the landing pads when trying to land? How do you avoid it? I had a mod that actually made it so I could fly low. I think it's just like the low fly mod or whatever. That thing's amazing. I highly recommend. Okay, we don't really need Mordite or Coprite. Or Sac Venom. Okay, so that's probably all the stuff in my starship inventory. We should probably offload some of the stuff from our freighter, too. Because I don't think we need half the crap that we've got loaded on there. But that's okay. Yeah, we definitely don't need any more Pugnium or Sac Venom. Alright, this should help. I still probably need some of the rarer resources, at least for a little while, but we'll figure it out. But yeah, Even if aliens could get to us, I doubt they would bother with this backwater planet. No, you're totally right about that. I like Earth. I think Earth is nice, but I don't think aliens would really be well served. Ooh. Aliens would be particularly well served. Why am I looking at this ship? There's nothing it could offer me. I only want fighters right now. Because at this point I've got max size, so I didn't even have to think about it. But yeah, like, at this point, it's polluted as all hell and has all sorts of problems. So, yeah, why do I have to care? Oh, Korzagan. Alright, this actually seems like a halfway decent, I think I've been to that Atlas interface. Which is... I think I missed. Alright, we'll wait for a second. But yeah, no, I don't think we have to worry too much about aliens just randomly wiping us off. Okay, Fervidium. Okay, there's another... There's got to be another planet here. It's on the other side. What's on yellow Savlololololol? Temerium. Is it? It is Temerium. Okay, there we go. Probably gonna have to refuel you quick. Luckily, I got enough fuel, so we should be fine. Okay, here we go. Oh yeah, that's another thing this game really needs. Water features. Like, seriously. But I don't know. I don't know what the future of No Man's Sky is going to be, but it's probably going to be... gonna remain mildly disappointing, and that's, I guess, okay. Not every game has to be good. And honestly, after playing Astroneer, I'm just kind of like, eh, somebody else will pick up the torch and make something amazing. I just have to be patient. Or impatient and keep playing this. Yeah, one thing I actually have to decide with all of this is, when the hell am- oh god. It's just a resource deposit-y thing. Nothing more. That's unfortunate. But yeah, like I was saying, one of the things I have to sit down and decide with this series is when the hell do we end it? Because we're, according to some people in my chat, we're actually pretty dang close to, we're actually pretty dang close to, maxing out every single quest available. Which is actually seriously awesome. Okay, it's just titanium. I don't care, I'll just grab the goodies at the base. It's not free money, but it's easy money. Okay. Mainly we're here for the Temerium. Humans would be good as slaves. I highly doubt humans would be viable slaves. Like, we'd probably be okay slaves. The main issue is just, what? If you're a giant spacefaring civilization, capable of enslaving an entire alien population, there's no way you need organic life forms as slaves. I mean, look at humanity already. We have slaves. They're robots. They don't complain. We have complete control over their existence, and it's awesome. And nobody generally complains about it. Whereas, like... if an entire... the only reason why a spacefaring civilization would enslave humanity was... would, I think, probably, largely be because... they hate us. Or they think we look ugly or something like that. I don't know. I mean, there's a billion ways to do it. But yeah, robots make way better slaves... than humans ever would. We whine a lot. But yeah, I think... mostly, if intelligent life did exist, they'd probably just look at us and add us as an oddity. And largely either leave us alone or, you know, visit just because, I don't know, eat food together. Alright, we probably want to hop out. I'll put one of these beacons down. I don't have any more iron. What? Right. Spent it all fixing up my shields. Forgot about that part. until the robots revolt. I don't think we'd ever get to a point. What's a good example? I don't think we'd ever get kind of the equivalent of Skynet or the oh shit, what were the robots called in Battlestar Galactica? Cylons. I don't think we'd ever get to that point. I think once we get to actually, like, intelligent AI, we are going to have some weird social issues, but I don't think they're going to be, like, the robots rule the world or anything like that. It'll probably just be, like, robots past a certain intelligence threshold are no longer, you know, would actually have certain rights and classifications and stuff. I doubt we'd ever get to the point, the Borg. The Borg seems a little bit more likely, but also stupid, because why would robots ever, ever want biological components? Oh, right, I was supposed to go for a, base as well, but whatever. Yeah, I don't know, it always bothered me that the Borgs were, like, assimilating people, and it's like, why? Why assimilate? Just kill the humans, make non-organic Borg for whatever reason. You're fucking laser proof. You don't need biological components. I don't know. I love sci-fi, but man, there's some serious plot holes to deal with. It'd be interesting. Usually when I'm just thinking about it now, somebody in chat said they just sit back and watch which country destroys itself first. That's actually something I've wondered about a couple of times. In a lot of sci-fi civilizations, they always show, well, they always talk about how, like, humanity gets, probably should have saved my thamium in retrospect, whatever. They always have, like, humanity kind of unifying under one banner for whatever reason. And that always confuses me. Because I find it really hard to believe that all of humanity would unify under one government, even in, like, a fully spacefaring civilization. But then again, I have no idea. I also don't care that much. It's just kind of an interesting idea. Alien species could use humans for biological factories. For certain proteins, enzymes, etc. But humans are already almost entirely capable of doing that already with technology. Again, like, at any point where, like, a robot would need... or be at all interested in, or at any point where, like, a spacefaring civilization would potentially have use for humanity as, like, slaves, we'd already be past that point. The only way I could see anybody wanting to enslave humanity is if somehow our tech level's, like, surpassing theirs, and they want to enslave humanity to, I'm going to say catch up and stuff like that, which makes no sense because at that point it would be hard as hell to conquer us with lower tech unless they were just more numerous, but I don't know. Whatever, these are weird hypotheticals and generally make no sense to me. Sci-fi is also dumb and likes to put a lot of weird, dumb ideas into our head. Who is Wanderbot talking to? I mean, bits of myself and bits of responding to comments? I don't know. I'm talking to myself. You guys get to listen. Sometimes people get to rebut, but rarely. Oh, album and pearls. I don't really feel like dealing with album and pearls right now. I can grow them. There we go. I guess the one last exception would be humans as a food source, because humans are tasty. That actually would be something that could work. Slaves, force them into Colosseum battles. But, like, we got video games. I really do not see the point of, like, forcing shitty humans into shitty fights. When you could probably just as easily make really, really cool simulation games that are just as good. Let's see. Is there another small company that's made an indie game that has more depth compared to No Man's Sky? Really depends on what your perspectives are on things. I would say Starbound, Terraria, Ark, sort of. I don't know. It kind of depends on, like, where depth goes. Astroneer, if you're looking for something similar. Freaking... Astroneer is amazing. I hope that game develops quickly. Just like this game. I hope they develop this game faster. because I really... Wow, that is actually a really nice view. I super dig... Where's... There it is. I super dig... looking up and seeing a planet. I was complaining about skyboxes, but this is the skybox I want to look at. Not this. Well, I guess those clouds aren't as bad as other ones. Logic of video games is not addressing with people who could play football games before prefer real football sports. You're right, that is actually a hole in my logic. There are people that enjoy football more. It's just like, it'd be hard to get an entire population behind the idea of... God damn it, it's just more of these. I want Temerium! I don't want Album and Pearls. They're dumb. Yeah, Space Engineers. Empyrean. I don't know. No Man's Sky has depth. But there's a billion other indie games that have, I'd say, drastically surpassed what NMS offers. At least for the time being. Okay, we gotta go back to the ship. Oh, that's gonna hurt. Okay. Let's see. How much Temerium do we have? 24... 183. There we go. Okay. Ooh, yeah. Toxic protection is definitely falling. There we are. Good timing. All right, I'm going to pop out and make a beacon, and then we'll go from there. You're about to die. Actually, no. Once your protection fails, you're actually fine. It just slowly hurts your shields. Originally, I was actually super afraid of running out of my toxic protection, but it turns out it's actually like not actually a big deal. It's kind of a shame, but whatever. Okay, check for another drop pod. Don't show me the drop pod I'm directly next to. Okay, that's good. Unfortunately, I'm also starting to get like really nauseous feeling. It just went from really cold in here to really warm, and that's not a good feeling. Well, let's grab the Okay, that manufacturing plant is on the other side of the planet. So let's go for the drop pod first. That's not the drop pod I was looking for. Or that is. There, no, that's a habitable base. That's garbage. Here we are. Drop pod all the way over here. But yeah, no, you don't actually die if you run out of toxic protection. You actually just take some shield damage, and you can just keep throwing points at iron at your shields, and you could live forever, which is really weird and kind of lame, actually. Actually, I almost would prefer it if it killed you, if you got down to zero. Whatever. Oh, that better not be Album and Pearls. I really hope it's Temerium, so I don't have to come back. Okay. I'm gonna need to go make some more money. I think I'm gonna be able to fill up my inventory slots before then. I know. That looks encouraging. This might be a bit of a pain to get out of. Eh, I think we'll be fine. Oh yeah, this is the stuff. Yeah, so I think I'll just grab this set of Temerium and then we'll get out of here. I can find habitable bases on any planet and I don't really feel like sticking around. Is that all of them? I think that's all of them. Are you anything? You are nothing. like trying to demoralize inanimate objects in video games. Truly worth my time. Okay, I don't see any goodies, but I really like this view. I don't remember how to turn off my interface. Show HUD H. Unfortunately, much to my general chagrin, it still doesn't turn off half of my interface, which pisses me off a bit. Get rid of the rest of it, dingus. Alright, whatever. Oh, photo mode. I actually don't know how to go into photo mode. I just know I can turn it off yet. Let's see, where's my ship? There's my ship. Photo mode under options. Okay, let's get up here. Options. Oh, photo mode. Not as nice of a view. Also, the lighting is kind of screwed up, but that's okay. Alright, let's turn photo mode back off. I really wish there was a hotkey for photo mode on and off. Well, it's nice that they included it. Shame the storm had to clear up just as I was doing it. Alright, let's get out of here. Right. Let's go. Alright, stuff like that. My head hurts, and it sucks. Amusing yet probably scientifically correct situation. There are planets that are composed of, like, 50% diamond. I think you're actually right about that. So, I don't know how many of you guys watch other YouTube things or whatever. I think... God, I don't even remember. Which... I think it's College Humor, but there's a series called Adam Ruins Everything, and he goes over why diamonds are, like, the biggest scam in the world and stuff like that. And, but yeah, no, diamonds are actually, like, fairly common and kind of useless. Well, apart from, like, mining and whatever, they're, like, not actually nearly as fancy as we make them out to be. But yeah, no, I could totally believe there being a fully diamond planet. Which would be really freaking cool. I'd love to see a planet composed almost entirely... And you're not going to catch me. Okay. We're just going to awkwardly, like, tip off the side of this. And there we go. Okay, it is... College Humor. Humor. I don't know. Could be fun. I'd love to see weird planets like that. I'd love to see more games... that kind of approach weird shit like that. I'm hoping Mass Effect Andromeda kind of makes a bunch of interesting planets. Unfortunately, right now it seems a little bit on the lame side, but that's okay. Right, we don't want to go through this one. We want to go through the other way. Okay. Hate it when the heat turns on in here because it blasts a lot of hot air for a very short period of time. Makes me start to sweat, then it immediately turns off and I go back to being cold. Ugh. Oh, whatever. Okay, let's get over here. Sort of, maybe, yes, base, yes. Alright, I should have more than enough temerium that I can warp home. And, and get the scientist thing. And push that further. I don't know, we'll see. I did not get nearly as many things done as I wanted to today, but we did finish Last Guardian, which is a huge, huge bonus from my perspective. Yeah, it is 2:30. I should be going to bed soon. Very soon. I always feel bad when people, like, join my stream just as I'm slowly getting to the point where I'm gonna go to bed. Oh, I always feel super guilty for that. Can't wait until we're done with all these quests so I can focus on making a really interesting base. Okay, anyway. Here's your temerium. Okay, so now we can make acid. Hey! You know, the one thing I actually am really disappointed about, okay, insulating gel needs work. Based my formula on a language that's not my own, gleaned from a nearby monolith. Perhaps I missed something. Will you visit the site? Find a clue. Okay. It will resolve the confusion. Gotcha. Okay. I wanna talk to him again. I forgot to read the other section. Okay. I wanna see this. Get this out of here. The fumes hanging over my scientist's workstation are less noxious than before, but their equipment is covered with a thin layer of translucent slime. They've been working on an insulating gel, but are unable to complete the formula. Perhaps I can help. Okay, there we go. Let's see. How far away are you? Far enough that I ain't walking that. And I remember when I was... there we go. Luckily, I am freaking just covered in plutonium. Makes this a lot easier and stuff like that. Okay. Let me see. What was I gonna say? Hell if I remember. Super sucks. Whee. I was talking about Mass Effect Andromeda. That'll be fun, hopefully. Hopefully. Hopefully they don't aim for the trilogy. I have looked over at YouTube, which is playing old footage, because for whatever reason it always just like slowly gets out of sync. What? Do you not have any... You don't have any goodies for me. Oh, I've already been to this one. Go figure. Maybe? Maybe not. I don't know. Covering yourself in plutonium is very bad for your health. Shh. Okay, so knowledge imparted. I really wish the artifacts like were deeper into and do stuff and whatever, but that's okay. But yeah, I look over at YouTube. We need more spadonium for temerium or insulating gel. Gotcha. Well, I've got some amount of spadonium. Please tell me I have enough space buds to make whatever I want. I got 100. Yeah, I don't know. Apparently you don't need acids in this game. Hey! Oh yeah, that's what I was gonna say. I'm actually really disappointed that the... Yep. I have in fact been there before. This is all stuff I've been to. I'm actually really disappointed. Let's see, is this anything interesting? Doesn't look too cool. I don't know, don't care too much. Once they had a land vehicle, I'll probably drive around and maybe check this place out. I don't know. I don't really like this planet. It's just the only planet with grass, so it's the only planet I'm willing to leave my base on. Problem is the grass is just this weird... Oh, you can farm spadonium. Okay, good. Do I not already have a spadonium farm? Speaking of grass, I think it's kind of taken over parts of my base. Okay, farming. Corporate orb. I think it's yelling at me saying this isn't indoors. That could be a problem. Okay. Here we go. Okay, good lubricant is vital whenever there are moving parts. If you don't like the smell, there may be a solution. The Korvax developed olfactory blocker that will neutralize any odor. They're Korvax convergence cubes. They hold the key to its manufacture. Then again, you can always hold your nose. Luckily, I've already got a stock of these, so I don't have to worry about it. Awesome. Okay, so now we got lubricant, which we get from Mordite. Okay, what next? I haven't done all the farm quests. Nope, I need other things. Okay, there's no room for error when working with explosives. I could stabilize this formula with rubium, an element that occurs only on the rocks of red star systems. Do you have any? The sooner this job is done, the sooner we can all relax. Okay, I've been warned that my scientist is experimenting with explosive materials today. As I approach, they're cursing in their native tongue. In an attempt to calm them, I ask them if there's anything I can do to help. A supply of rubium, they tell me, would make their work much less dangerous or difficult. Okay, don't I have some rubium hanging out on one of these ships? Probably on the freighter. Trophium. Nope, don't have rubium. Thought I had a bunch of it. Man, I don't even remember what rubium looks like. Oh, that's not useful. Rubium. I might have some amount of that. I'm just gonna write these things down. Alright. I don't think we need these anymore. Alright. Okay. Oh, he needs insulating gel. Oh, he has a galactic trade terminal up for grabs. That's awesome. We just gotta do it. And you needed Rigogen, I believe. Yes, Rigogen. Okay, so yeah, we'll have to do these. Unfortunately, we have to go find another aquatic planet, and that's a little bit harder than I thought it would be. Which kind of sucks, but that's okay. I'm just glad I can farm things. Some of these are rarer than others. Well, this'll keep us, oh, what am I thinking? Well, funded for a long time, especially if I can put a trade terminal in there. Aha! Anyway, I'm gonna pop out. And there we go. Restore point save. Oh, right. I just want to finish that ramp from earlier that I keep starting and forgetting. I really wish that the armorer in my space station sold me guns or let me upgrade guns and equipment and stuff. Okay, this planet looks kind of okay. I don't know. I still don't like it as much. Wish it had more blue. But, you know, the armorer actually let me get suit upgrades that increased my defensive capabilities and, you know, new guns and weapons. Like, it'd be so cool if he actually served as a function to get me more stuff as opposed to being like, well, I don't got more shit for you. Bye. And that's the end of it. I don't know. Just kind of super lame to me. But whatever.